What is up, YouTube, and welcome back to the channel. Today, I bring you the 2021 Subaru Impreza. Introduced in 1992, the Subaru Impreza is here in its fifth generation. Now, this fifth generation includes something called Subaru's Global Platform, which means they're building pretty much most of their Subarus on this exact chassis. Now, it is about 100% stronger than the last chassis or more rigid. It sits a little bit lower, and guess what? It saves money. Now, they make the Subaru in a four-door sedan, and they make it in a five-door hatch, such as this. And they make it in four different variants. The first one's called Convenience, the second one's called Touring, then the Sport, and then this, which is called the Sport Tech, because it's got tech. But besides that, the starting price of the four-door sedan starts at a measly $19.95 in a five-speed manual transmission. Yes, you can get this in a five-speed manual transmission with a 2-liter boxer engine for it's actually $1,000 more for the wagon, but that is cheap. $19.95 is what they start at. Manual transmission, all-wheel drive, Subaru. I'm excited to test one of our first normal cars. So on the front of the vehicle, we've got these boomerang front LED daytime running lights. Now, this is the crazy part about this Subaru. We've had the Crosstrek, and the Crosstrek on the model we had halogens and halogens. Now on this specific one, this is the top of the line, as I mentioned, Impreza, you get LEDs and LED fog lights up and down. Now Subaru hasn't been one to really push the design envelope. Usually most Japanese or even domestic product are becoming really rounded and futuristic. They've got a lot of these crazy designs to try to make it stand out. But Subaru, they just decided to keep it sort of simple, because in this fifth generation, it still sort of just looks simple, and that's the theme of this video. This is as simple as you can get in a vehicle, and as we go through it, you'll realize they've just made it simple. But even though it is simple, there's a lot of small features here that are crazy on a price this low. Like, take a look, they've got active grille shutters on the front. Active grille shutters at this price point. Now, as I mentioned, there's four different variants you can get in the Impreza, and they all have an addition of something called EyeSight. Now, if you look at, you know, we've reviewed a lot of cars, but if you look at the Audis as an example, they have their front sensing system all in a radar, sort of hidden here or hidden here, or most manufacturers do have that. But in Subaru, they've actually opted to put it up top, and they call it EyeSight. And what that does is essentially it's two eyes. But here's some of the issues. With EyeSight, if you have ice up here or anything blocking, it doesn't work. And that's similar to some of the ones that have in the bumper. If it's blocked in by ice, it also doesn't work. And these features sort of include front radar, automatic cruise control, lane centering, all that fun stuff. Now, if you look under the hood here, you guys are probably expecting to see a 2.5-liter boxer engine that was in the Crosstrek. And unfortunately, you cannot get that motor in the Impreza. You can only get this 2-liter, you guys ready for this? 2-liter non-turbo, naturally aspirated motor that makes 152 horsepower and 145 foot-pounds of torque. Now, this thing does have variable valve control. It also does have direct injection, so it's got all the latest modern tech, but only makes that much horsepower and torque. Now, in this sort of category, most stuff makes almost 200, if not blow right past 200. So why such a weak engine? So if you stick around to the end of this video, it is blatantly obvious on why they use this engine. More into that. But on the side of the vehicle here, I like how this sits a little bit lower. Now this does have sport suspension, so it sits 5 millimeters lower. And that is obviously thanks to Subaru's new global platform frame. But another piece I like on this, and it's similar to what Kia has, is they have proximity touch on the doors. You simply just walk to it and pull the handle. There's no button to push. It's just walk up to it, pull it. It's got proximity. It knows you're there and you walk in. Now it's only on the front doors and not on the back doors. And everything else is pretty sort of standard. I do like the five-door version over the sedan. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. And what do you guys think about these wheels? Subaru. Wheels? You never think Subaru and wheels, but these wheels actually look really good. And in terms of insulation, and that's a piece I want to talk about. So in the front here, it is plastic, and in the back here, it is plastic. Sort of plastic with a bit of hair. Now, I've met many Subaru owners throughout my life that will say they will spend another $1,000 or even $2,000 to have better insulation, because that's probably one of Subaru's flaws, is the insulation on the Imprezas are just a little bit scant. They need to have a bit more insulation. So if you own a Subaru or have owned a Subaru, would you guys pay that extra money for more insulation? Let me know. And flipped around. So on the back here, I guess they didn't really take the same theme in the front. This thing is a bit more choppy, but it is definitely a bit more out there. And it's got a bit more of the other Subaru sedans in mind when it comes to this taillight. It really sticks out. Now, I do like the fact that it does say all-wheel drive, because at least everybody lets everybody know you can't get front-wheel drive in Canada. You can only get it in all-wheel drive, which is nice to know. But there is something cool here, and check this out. There is the button. It's not fully centered, but it opens the trunk, not powered. But they have a secondary button here, and that's to lock the car. And that is cool, because it's on the outside, not on the inside. You see, Audis, when you open them up, they've got two buttons, to close the trunk and then to lock the trunk and walk away, and then it locks the doors. But in this specific case, you just simply press this button, key in your hand, and you walk away. As far as trunk room goes, we've got from the back of the rear seats to the sill plate here, we've got 31 inches. So you've got 31 inches from the back to the front. And as you know, all our videos will have how much depth we have in terms of space. Now, as far as everything else, you've got this rear sort of tonneau cover, probably not the best quality in the world, but it makes do. This thing does have the largest passenger seat in its class, because they have made this Subaru platform wider and longer, as I mentioned. So that's a bonus. If you're looking for a larger back passenger room, this is the largest in its segment. Big things. All right, so in the front of the vehicle, it does have the cool pedals. Now, it's got these WRX pedals, which is nice to have. I know this is not a WRX, but it's got WRX pedals. It does have the same steering wheel from the Crosstrek we had, with the exception of the color. I would have liked this to be blue. It's blue on the outside, give me blue here. You did it in the Crosstrek, give it to me here. Anyways, as far as everything else goes, this does have power driver seat, which you might think is an anomaly, but Subarus, the Imprezas, didn't have power driver seat for the longest time in today's world. But hey, look at this dash. This center console dash is actually lower than the driver cluster. And most cars nowadays have the center dash up high and the cluster lower. But this is reversed. The center infotainment is actually lower. But everything else is like the Crosstrek, fairly practical, fairly plasticky, and you kind of know what you're getting out of it. Now, they've added some small touches with the carbon fiber look, but it's not really carbon fiber, it's just little tiny squares, because here it looks gray, and now that that door's open, it looks silver. Other tidbits to know is an iPhone 12 Max does not fit in this sort of center compartment. It's a little bit too small. I wish they would put wireless charging in there so we could use it as a wireless charger. But I do like the fact they've got just basic gauges with red needles. That's nice to have. I also do like, if you look up top, they do have this sort of information center like they do have in the Crosstrek. But again, like the Crosstrek, they use the exact same infotainment. And I really don't like the fact that when you want to go through your music and you want to turn the volume up, as soon as you turn the volume up, the whole screen just becomes the volume amount. Whereas it should just give you the volume amount in a very small way to show you, but it takes over the whole screen and it stays on there for like a good 3 seconds. But that's probably my only complaints with the infotainment. Other than that, everything just works. It's practical. It's kind of unbreakable. They even give you a manual handbrake, which is so much nicer than the electronic one that engages half the time. You're trying to roll the car back to check if you're in the right spot. Well, the electronic parking brake comes on. In this specific case, you can just roll, you know, like normal drivers did once upon a time. But onto some real positive pieces. This thing has four USBs. It's got two in this center glove box here. It's also got a cigarette lighter, and it's got two USBs right up front, along with another cigarette lighter. It also has a little 3.5 millimeter jack that you can put your audio in. But other pieces that I do like, I really love these paddle shifters. These paddles are just so nice and very, very good paddle shifters. Now, we're gonna test them on the road to see how they work. But I just like the way they look. They're nice and sharp. They actually stick up above the steering wheel. And this is probably one of the better steering wheels in the car business. It gives you all the data you need. It also gives a heated steering wheel and this red stitching on the inside. So all in all, I'm really happy with those type of pieces. But again, think about what this costs. $33,000 Canadian. And you do get Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. But before we take this for a drive, I want to show you one small final thing. And check this out. Look at that. I hit the brakes and it lights up. Like, that's so small, but that's so cool. So let's take this thing on the road and see how it drives. All right, so now I'm inside the 2021 Subaru Impreza and we're gonna take this thing for a drive. But before I do, I wanna show you how fast this is from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour. And part of this exercise is to see how slow it is with this engine. Because there's a reason, as I mentioned. So let's take out my handy-dandy stopwatch. I'm gonna hold it here and we're gonna go from 0 to 100. Hopefully you guys can see this and it's not too reflective. But let's go. You guys ready? 1, 2, 3, foot to the ground, and go. All right, let's go. We got 40, 60, 80, 100. 9.72 seconds. Wowzers. Well, there's a reason for that. And before I go into all the depths of how this car drives and all this stuff, and my reasoning on why they put this engine in is because this is the best car for teens. Because think about it. You've got good all-wheel drive. You've got a great chassis. This is, nice little slip and slide. Great steering. Now, you obviously can't see it because you're seeing my mug, but it's for teens. Great price point. Safe, because it won the IIHS for Safe Top Safety Award, blah, blah, blah. And yeah, that's what it's for. It's for new drivers. Yeah, duh, Mike, everybody knows that. But no, think about it. There's tons of cars that make a ton of power. You'd want to give your kids something that doesn't make too much power. And that is my reasoning on why they put this motor in here. There's just no other valid reason. They should have put the 2.5 liter motor in here. Or maybe because they wanted to step up you by the Crosstrek, but no. Back to the CVT noise. It just stays there. But they simulate the gears to make it feel more natural, more normal. But most CVTs just hold the RPM pretty much almost at redline or at their peak. But this one has simulated gears. I've had this car pretty much most of the week, and what I will say is that it's just a very, very good daily driver. It's awesome. You get in it, you start it. You don't have to wait till it warms up. You just drive it. Some cars you got it, you start it, and it just feels like tight when you first get into it when it's cold out. But this thing starts up, it drives normal. It's very, very easy to drive. Like, the easiness to drive, I cannot stress how easy this thing is to drive. Now, Ian, lucky guy, he picked up his brand new 2021 Mazda 3 GT Turbo, which we're gonna take for a cruise and test it out next week. But that was also easy to drive, but this is easier to drive. This is easier. The steering is just very light. The in and out position, it's got a ton of trunk room. It does have all the safety features because this one has eyesight. So yeah, very, very good first car. Now, there's no real sex appeal with it. There's no real draw because people are not like, man, I wanna get myself a Subaru Impreza. Not really. It doesn't have that draw, but it does everything very, very well. It's like the king of satisfactory. Maybe king of better than satisfactory on the survey that you're gonna fill out. But it's got a little bit of feedback there. Shifting's very smooth. I have a really, really big soft spot for these engines that just don't make enough power, but they try really, really hard. And you gotta really work them for them to move. And this is kind of it. We do get some speed because the CV transmission makes up for it and always keeps us in the right power band. But we're just working it just to get some speed. I just like it. Just think about this. If you're not a car person, you walk into a dealership and every dealership you go into, they're just blasting with the round looks and the tech and all that fancy stuff that takes away from the real practicality of a car. And then you walk into a Subaru dealership and they talk about all-wheel drive, they talk about IIHS safety, top safety pick. You sit in here, you see a lot of plastic hard buttons that can get wet and not really destroyed. You see these regular gauges and a fairly basic practical interior that can get beat up, that can get dirty, that can get worn down. And then you hear that it holds better than any other car resale value. You're thinking to yourself, maybe I should consider this Subaru, because Well, tons of other people have, because I was in a little town called Canmore, which is just outside Banff, and we went hiking. And there was about 40 cars in the parking lot, and 35 of them were Subarus. Yeah, they're buying them. Catch you next time.